Hello friends, welcome back. Thank you for your great support. So today's video is preparing Bisibele Bath powder and also Bisibele Bath at home. The history of Bisibele Bath from Mysore Palace of Karnataka. The Bisibele Bath recipe is very popular in locality and also globally. Most of us would love to enjoy the taste of real authentic Bisibele Bath. So check out the description box for more information about the video. So here, let's go for a preparation. So the recipe begins with a frying list of ingredients: coriander seeds, urad dal, chana dal, poppy seeds, jeera or cumin seeds, dry methi seeds, sesame seeds, clove, pepper, green cardamom, cinnamon stick. So friends, do not overheat the pan to fry this spices. So just make the pan hot, then you can start frying in a very low flame. In order to do that, you can first add the spices or this list of ingredients, then you can on the stove. So fry in the low flame for 1 minute or 2 minutes until the aroma turns out. So after frying, it's ready to remove. Keep it aside, let it cool down. Then we're gonna fry. Here I'm adding curry leaf and also dry coconut. So make sure there is no water in it. If you are taking fresh with water, then there is a chances of powder is getting spoiled. So make sure you will take the dried coconut and also curry leaf. So let it cool down for the grinding. Then we gonna fry chilies. To fry the chilies, add tablespoon of oil. You can add two types of chili. Fry it for 1 minute in a low flame. So after frying, let it cool down. Then we gonna grind it. So friends, most of the people would like to add hing and jaggery for the Bisibele Bath powder to prepare. So here I'm skipping it completely. If you wish, you can add it. So here batch wise batch, I'm adding the fried ingredients to grind. So while grinding, make sure to add tablespoon of salt. Then grind it as a finely powder. So this powder can be stored in an airtight container for more than 3 months. Now let's go for a cooking. So here I have used 1.5 cup of rice, 1/2 cup of dal, some veggies like carrot, beans, cauliflower, green peas. You can also add a veggie name called nukal or potato. Homemade Bisibele Bath powder, salt, ghee for the rice and veggies to cook. Add enough water. So mix it well. So let this veggies and rice cook in a pressure cooker for 1 to 2 whistles in a medium flame or high flame. Meanwhile, I'm gonna prepare ingredients ready for the Bisibele Bath masala. So here, after 2 whistles, the rice is perfectly done. I don't want rice to be too much cooked, kind of ganji. So this is the perfect consistency I'm expecting. So keep it aside. Now let's go for a Bisibele Bath masala to prepare. Here, add 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil. Once oil is hot, you can add mustard seed. So allow mustard seed to splatter. So some people would like to add hing again. Here I'm completely skipping it. Peanuts, you can increase or decrease the quantity of peanuts. then one onion, few curry leaf, dried chili. Fry it for 1 minute in a medium flame. So preparing this way of masala, bisibelebat masala for the rice. So it adds more taste for the rice. Then you can add capsicum 1 chopped, 2 tomatoes, salt, Kashmir chili powder, turmeric, homemade bisibelebat powder. So mix it very well. So let this cook for 2 to 3 minutes in a medium flame. So these powder should combine together with the capsicum, tomato, onions should cook. After 3 minutes of cooking, you can check it. The masala looks really attractive. Do not allow the masala to be burnt. Then you can add tamarind juice, some fresh coriander leaf. So cook it for another 1 more minute, then the masala is ready. So cooking this way of masala, it really adds more taste for the rice. So after cooking 1 minute, then you can add this masala to the rice. So friends, do try this way of bisibelebat, you will like it for sure. So don't forget to support, and also let us know your feedback after your trying the recipe. Add sufficient water, the consistency you are expecting to eat the bisibelebat, you can add the water accordingly. So here friends, you can also check out the salt and also water. So if it is required, you can add it, water little and also the salt, mix it well. So let this bisibelebat rice cook for 5 more minutes. And then we gonna give final tadka. So here add 2 tablespoons of ghee. So this ghee we are using to fry the cashews. This is the final tadka. So this way of adding ghee fried cashews, it will be very good smell and also very good taste for the rice. So this way of frying the cashews in the ghee, it adds more taste to the rice. When we are eating, you can feel the ghee smell and also the spicy bundi crunch with the well-cooked rice. So it will be superb taste. Do try, enjoy, you will like it for sure. So let's check out today's motivation. Don't place your mistakes on your head, their weight may crush you. Instead, place them under your feet and use them as a platform to raise yourself. So finally friends, Bisibele Bhat is ready. Enjoy the recipe. You will like it for sure. Thank you. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.